What's up, guys? Today we had the opportunity to interview Ricky Simmons. Ricky was a very cool guy. He's a former NFL player. Now he's a speaker, and he really just had some key things to say to us that helped us out, and he just talked about his journey. So we just want you guys to enjoy his interview and hope that you like it, because he really said some great stuff and he really spoke to us, and we hope that he speaks to you.
Yeah, so Ricky Simmons, man, he was actually a pretty cool dude. I had did a little research on him to see what he was about, and I like the fact that he puts all his flaws on front street so everybody can see. A lot of times people want to present themselves as a perfect human, but Ricky, he presents his flaws, and I like that because now you can't judge him. You can only go off what he gives you. And so he's a real genuine, sincere man, and he really helped us out a lot. All right, so everybody, I want y'all to check out this video, leave comments, subscribe, and let us know what you think about it. Also, Dream Leaders, we did produce and edit this video on our own, so we want you guys to judge too. So
we love you guys. Much love.
Much love. Dream Leaders. Hashtag it. Repost. Do whatever.
All social media. Follow us on Snapchat, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook.
Show love. Show love. We show love back. Just let us know, and we got you.
Peace out from Dream Leaders.
My dream when I was growing up here in Greenville was to become a football player and preferably to make it to the pros. Now, I wasn't sure exactly how I was going to go about doing it, but I knew it was going to require some work. So I started off Cattle Mills, first through the eighth grade, then I ended up changing over to Greenville School District in the ninth grade. And ninth through my senior year was here in Greenville. And it's pretty fitting that we chose this place here, because this is where it all started for me on the football scene. Looks a lot different now than it did at the time. But you know, actually brings back a lot of memories, because we had a lot of success here as a team. I think my senior year, we were 9-1, co-champs of the district. And at that time, 13-4A was top dog, you know, in the state. So we had some success, and very, very, very fortunate to have the opportunity to be a part of this, and brings back a lot of memories being here now. I was really motivated by my parents. For those that don't know, my parents are both in heaven. They've been gone 10 years now, but they were always very, very positive people, and they always encouraged me to do the best I could and to treat people the way I want to be treated and never forget where you came from. So I would have to say my parents. It was tough for me because I didn't handle it well. I made bad choices when I was faced with adversity, and the consequences were unbelievably rough. I went through quite a few struggles behind adversity. I think a lot of it has to do with peer pressure. You know, I think a lot of the stuff I did, I was doing it, but just because my friends were doing it. You know, and it made me make choices that I, in my clear mind, wouldn't have made. What's going on, man?
Not much. My name is Kevin Arvell.
How you doing, Kevin? I'm Ricky Simmons.
Me and my colleague have a company called Dream Leaders.
Okay.
And we're motivational speakers.
All right.
And I researched you, and I heard that you're also a motivational speaker.
Absolutely.
And I want to come ask you, what is the first thing to know about being a motivational speaker?
Make sure you remember to stay focused on whatever your topics are gonna be. You know, like me, I'm about being positive. You know, I'm not sure exactly what your topics will be, but make sure you research them and make sure you understand them, because a lot of times people are gonna question you.
Right.
You know, and you can't be going, You gotta, when they ask a question, you gotta smile at them and go, you know what, great question, and come right with your answer. So always stay focused on your topic.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, you're very welcome, man. And the pleasure's all mine. I had a lot of people that doubted my abilities, because especially playing football, I wasn't a big guy, you know, especially in high school. I think I was maybe, 5'10", 155, 160 at the max, soaking wet. So a lot of people talking about running back. Are you crazy? But, you know, like I said, my parents were very, very instrumental in this. They believed in me, which made me believe in myself. You know, so I'm not a big fan of people that are not going to encourage you, because to me, they fall into that category of what I call haters. When I first heard of Dream Leaders, I didn't really know what it was about. And, you know, I'm very careful what I attach myself to, because I'm not here to judge anyone, but I'm not here trying to co-sign nothing I don't want to co-sign. And when I first originally heard of Dream Leaders, I was thinking to myself, man, what is that about? You know, a bunch of youngsters. So I kind of assumed, which is never good, but I kind of assumed that, you know, it might not be all the way positive. But when once I had the opportunity to get involved with you guys and see what you guys were representing, and I actually, don't get it twisted, I followed you guys and I watched you guys. Or I wouldn't be standing right here right now, because I don't have to be doing this. I'm doing this because I want to be a part of Dream Leaders. You know, one of my biggest goals right now is to inspire people like yourselves, young men, to look at my past mistakes and learn from them. And don't duplicate me, be way better than me. Because to me, at the age of you guys right now, being, what, 20, 21, dude, the sky's the limit for you guys. And I want you guys not to waste valuable time and hope that you get it together later. Why wait till later when you can do it now?
How you doing, sir? My name is Dartana Wilson.
How you doing, man?
How you doing?
I'm Ricky Simmons, man. Nice to meet you.
I got a question for you.
Okay, what you got?
How do you deal with people that's not engaged to your speaking, or just people like, you know, you giving it your all, but they're not really just receiving it, and they're just...
Well, you got to understand something. That's part of the deal, but here's a catch. Raise your energy level. You know, I mean, it's a lot easier for people to stay focused when your energy's up. If you're standing there, for example, if you're just standing there behind a podium speaking, it's almost like you're lecturing people. Like me, myself, I don't use podiums when I speak. I'm too energetic for that. I'm gonna keep your focus on me, and you're gonna have to use, like, you're gonna raise your voice, you're gonna have to laugh, you're gonna have to be loud. In order to keep people's attention, you really have to use a lot of energy. I call it being a high energy speaker. And that's the one thing I would recommend that you take a look at.
Okay, thank you.
You're very welcome, man. You have a great day, man.
Nice meeting you.
No, pleasure's all mine. My name is Ricky Simmons, and I am a dream leader.
I'm the man.